Often means a trip to the shore, to the Poconos, but for some, they're going to new heights on their vacation. Custom limo tours, cooking and art classes, all involving marijuana. Fox 29's Chris O'Connell traveled to Denver, where the tourists are flocking for a mile-high vacation.
We were here on vacation for our anniversary.
Steve and Wanda Worsley thought, what better way to spend their romantic 7th anniversary vacation than visiting picturesque Denver, Colorado?
Wow.
But these lovebirds from Seattle didn't come for the Rocky Mountains. They came to go shopping for weed.
We figured while we were in town, we'd stop by and enjoy some of the legal recreation.
Welcome to Colorado's budding business of pot tourism.
Here, you just kind of walk in, show me your ID, and buy it.
These days, out-of-state tourists like the Worsleys are flocking to Denver's 350 recreational pot shops like this one on Denver's 16th Street Mall, smack dab in the middle of the city's busiest boulevard, right there next to the 7-Eleven.
Have you seen any people from Philadelphia?
I've seen tons of people from Philadelphia. I mean, Pennsylvania, New York, New Jersey.
I toured the Euflora Recreational Medicine Shop. This is a place where you can smell the bouquet of the latest high-grade pot strains and read about the daily pot specials on a tablet.
Something called Grape Ape. That's what it looks like.
But like many who come here, the Worsleys are shopping for edible marijuana products. From gourmet peanut butter cookies to colorful candies, chocolate bars, even massage oils, all infused with cannabis.
The medibles are the simplest kind of thing, especially when you're out and about, you know, walking around for the next 5 hours. You don't need to find a place to smoke. You know, you just eat a cookie and you're good to go.
And the customers may surprise you, young and old, blue collar to professional.
That's awesome. I wish every state kind of did this.
These women from Wisconsin had the same reaction many had from out of state.
Awesome. I love it.
Some companies offer marijuana-linked tours like spa treatments or mountain retreats. Some hotels leave guest brochures on how much and where to consume their pot. But how is this free-for-all on marijuana affecting Denver's inner cities, the people who live here? I took a drive to Northeast Denver to find out. That's where I ran into Pastor Leroy Thompson.
We had prostitution, we had gangs, drug addicts. It was run for your life.
Thompson says he successfully spent years trying to get rid of the drug dealers out of his neighborhood. Now his grandchildren finally have a safe place to play. He thinks the recreational legalization of marijuana is wrong in God's eyes and bad for the community.
Two laws we must obey, God's law and man's. God's law come before man.
But even opponents agree legal pot is now the new reality. And in the 7 months Colorado has made lighting up legal, the state has brought in nearly $26 million in tax revenue, much of it coming from out-of-staters like the Worsleys. Some think what's happening here may be a sign of what's to come in Pennsylvania and New Jersey.
People seem to be supportive of it, I think, because they're realizing that it's not interactive with everybody else's personal lives. It's not being pushed on other people. It's something people can enjoy in their homes.
In Denver, Colorado, Chris O'Connell, Fox 29 News.